Hi, my name is Charlotte Wurmser, and I'm applying for the 2025 NASA CS Internship Program. Let me tell you a bit about myself. I live in Montclair, New Jersey, which is around 12 miles outside of New York City, with my parents and my cats, Aster and Aya. I have two older sisters, Serena and Sylvie. Sylvie's in college in Massachusetts, and Serena's an astronomer in Hawaii. I'm in 10th grade, and I go to Montclair High School, the same high school Buzz Aldrin went to. Here are some STEM programs that I'm lucky enough to have participated in. In 6th and 7th grade, I entered a national competition called Project CS Girls, where the challenge was to invent a product relating to science and technology. In 6th grade, I competed with a partner and we created a GPS multi-tool for the wilderness, earning us a spot as national semi-finalists. And in 7th grade, I invented a stationary bike that generates power, and I earned my spot as a national finalist. The summer before 8th grade, I spent 3 weeks at Franklin and Marshall College in Lancaster, Pennsylvania, through the Johns Hopkins CTY program, and I was in the paleobiology group. We covered Earth's history through the view of some of the different cells and creatures of the time, and I still love and think about some of the fossils that we learned about and excavated ourselves. Last summer, after 9th grade, I took part in a 5-week program called Weston Science Scholars at Montclair State University. I was in a group doing research on heavy metal soil contaminants found in an abandoned rail yards in Liberty State Park. We worked in the lab every day and then presented our findings to our parents and fellow lab students. When I wasn't in the lab for Weston, I was working on designing and building a built-in dresser for my closet. I built the entire thing from a handsaw and an electric drill, all from a pile of lumber. My school offers an introductory automotive class, which I took last year and loved so much that I, along with a couple of other students, was able to convince the teacher to have an advanced automotive class that I'm currently in. In the class, we're in charge of maintaining all of our school district vehicles. I love working on the engines and learning how to fix every possible problem, from a rusted truck bed to a snapped parking brake cable, on all sorts of different vehicles. This year, I was part of my school's Science Olympiad Club. My partner and I came in second place for geological mapping, helping our team also come in second place overall in regionals, meaning that we're going to be advancing to states in the next few months. Here are some other programs and hobbies that I do. I'm part of my school's Key Club, which allows me to stay connected to my town and community and help as much as I can. This year, I competed with my school's Model Congress team at Yale for my first time and won an award in the full committee session, which was out of around 80 people, for presenting my bill and the uses of AI in school settings. My favorite hobby is photography, and I do it as much as I can. I mainly love nature photography and astrophotography, but I've also taken pictures for some of my high school's sports teams. I also love cooking and baking. I make dinner for my family most weeks, trying every cuisine that I can find the ingredients for. And when I have enough time, I make sourdough bread or chocolate croissants. I also love playing sports. I played soccer for a really long time, and I was the captain on 3 of my different teams, so I learned a lot about working with different people who have different ideas. This past winter, I decided to try a new sport, so I joined my school's crew team, and I can't wait to get out on the water for the first time in the spring. Now, for the main question, why seas? My hope for CS is that it can help me connect different passions of mine, like engineering and stargazing, into a path for me to follow along into college and even a career. The research opportunity at my local university showed me how cool it is to be able to answer questions through research in a lab, as well as building my love for working in science even more. I've always been fascinated with space and all of the unknowns that come along with it. I love going outside at night to a local park or a wildlife conservation with my camera and tripod. I've taken pictures of the comet that was briefly visible, Comet A3, behind a World War I memorial in my town, the Aurora Borealis when it was visible even in light-polluted northern New Jersey, and for the eclipse in April, my family and I drove all the way to northern Vermont to see totality. For the past few years, my family's luxury has been traveling to a different national park each year. Not only do these trips allow me to view the U.S. completely differently, driving from New Jersey through the Great Plains to eventually get to Great Basin National Park in Nevada, showed me how precious and crucial something that I thought of as abundant, water, was while going through drought-affected areas. But also, these trips allowed me to see the startling effects of light pollution. Coming from a town right outside of New York City, the city that never sleeps, and going to one of the darkest locations in all of America was breathtaking. On a moonless night, the Milky Way was so bright that I was able to see my own shadow clearly. I hope this opportunity will help show me different research and career pathways in the fields that I love, and allow me to work with and become friends with people who view the world and our universe with the same wonder that I do. Thank you so much for considering me.